Hi everyone. So today is Flexi Friday, but today I'm going to be flexing in the shoulders, which isn't very flexible to be honest, because I do aerial, my shoulders are really quite tight, but I'm going to do some stretches for them anyway, and some twists, some hip opening, just general basic stretches for mobility. So if you want to join me, now is the time. And as always, please subscribe, like and share both channels. So that's Nick's Fitness Academy and Nick's Fitness Academy. Much appreciated, thank you. Okay, so if you're flexible in the shoulders, you can add blocks to these stretches to get deeper. Okay, as I said, my shoulders are not the most flexible, so I'm happy with that. Okay, so first we're going to take one hand to the end of the mat, the other hand further back, and then we're going to push all the way back and try and get as low as we can with that straight arm looking towards the hand that you took further back. Keep pushing down, remember to breathe, enjoy that stretch. Good, and now we're going to switch sides. Exactly the same, guys, but on the other side. Good. Okay, so the next one is a little thread through, so we're going to bring in our right arm through the gap all the way, and then open up that chest. And now we're getting that twist. So the more you pull around, the deeper the stretch. And then let's switch side, exactly the same on the other side. Bring it back. Good. Okay, we're going to come down to sitting and we're going to bring our left leg over our right. Make sure that both bum cheeks are on the floor, and then we're going to bring our right arm over our left knee. Push back with the arm and twist to look behind yourself. The more you push back, the bigger the stretch. Good. And let's do the same on the other side. So now it's the left arm up and over, push back and twist. Good. Good. Okay. I'm going to go back onto my hands and knees. Hands under shoulders, knees under hips, and we're going to circle the middle. And now I'm going to arch my back. I'm going to round my back. to my back. Really pushing into the wrists. Good. Okay. So now I'm going to put my elbows on the floor and my palms facing me. Okay. This one kind of works better if you do have blocks or you're leaning on something. But I'm just going to do it without. Okay, so hands and knees into that prayer hand position
and head through. So obviously if you were elevated, you'd be able to get your head lower and push down more, which would give you a deeper stretch.
Together behind. I'm going to pull down and up a bit. Prayer hands all the way up the spine. And then push the hands in, open the elbows. Stay where you are and push the hands in, open those elbows. And release that, let's circle those wrists. I'm just going to stay facing this way for the next one. Okay, so we're going to bring one arm up and over, and then we're going to try and meet the hands together. Now I know that on the other side, I can't touch normally, so you can grab a strap or something. Let's try it. Oh, we've got a finger. That'll do. Much tighter in the right arm. Back together, pull. Good. Okay, keeping the crossed legs, we're going to bring our forearms to the floor and reach across. If you can't get your forearm down, just use your hand. And then the other way. Opposite knee, let's turn around, pull back on the knee. And then the other side. Good. Let's just give those shoulders a roll back. Head side to side. Sitting on one hand, bring the other arm over and gently give your head a pull. And then the same on the other side. Shoulders should be feeling a little bit more loose. Okay. So, let's bring our left leg forward into lunge. Elbows down if you can. Use blocks or something if you can't reach the floor. Pushing up, toes to the sky, reaching forward. Keep that leg straight. I'm just going to come to the side of that leg, add a little twist in. Keep low, push back on the leg with the arm. Switch it. Right leg forward into lunge. Elbows down. Pushing up, toes to sky, leg straight. And let's add that twist in, bring that left arm across, stay as low as you can, really twist. Good, send it back. Okay, we're gonna put the left toes underneath, push back with the heel. Another round. Feel that calf stretch. Okay, bringing our left leg into pigeon. Relaxing down. into the arched back. Good. And now switch sides. Relaxing down. So I'm pushing all my weight onto this straight leg side. Optional now, you can either hold another lunge or a hamstring stretch, or you can do splits with me. You decide. As long as you get in a stretch, that's all it's about. Circle it off, you can. How was that? Was it good? Good. Okay, so next I'm going to come into double pigeon. So ankle and knee in one line, other foot on top of the knee and above the other ankle. Just add your hand on the top of the knee for some extra pressure. If it's already down, you can add something under this foot, make it a little harder. Let's circle it round. To the middle. good. Just switching sides. So again, ankle and knee one line, other foot on top. Add the hand extra pressure. Add some drift under the foot if you need to. And remember, you can always pause these videos and take your time to copy. You can do it slower, hold stretches longer. Okay, let's circle. Just focus on your breath and try and relax that tension around the hips, around the glute. Let it go. Coming up, good. So this side's a little tighter on mine. I'm just gonna spend some time just holding this side down. Bring one leg bent to the side and the other leg completely to the side. So really trying to get both legs to the side as much as you can. Yeah. And then we're going to push down on the bent side, reach towards that straight leg's toes. Use a strap if you need to. Grab your leg higher. Okay, good. Now we're going to come into our straddle. Feel the stretch on the inner thigh. Push down on the thighs. Keep those legs straight. hands behind, let's push the hips forward and hold. Sit nice and tall. Good. See if you can go further forward. Again, push those hips forward and hold. Sit nice and tall. Reach forward, keep those knees up. Time, bring it in. Okay, we're going to reach to the side. And then the other side. Good. See if you can move forward. Hold that position. Push those hips forward. Good. And push to the middle, tailbone under. Bring those legs in. And squeeze those legs. Oh, give them a cuddle because they worked hard. You can even lie down and bring them in. Have a little rock. Good. Okay, so we're going to bring our right hand over to the left and drop those knees. And look the other way. And now the other side. Ooh. Back to the middle, roll yourself up. We're going to give our hips a little circle. Maybe our knees, get any tight spots clicked out. Whatever it is we need to do, I know I have to. I'm just going to stretch the feet. I'm going to push the toes under and push down through the ankle. Especially if you are a dancer, we need to keep these feet stretched. And then the other side, so toes under, and push forward through the ankle. So some people, when you say point your toes, they literally do this. But we want a pointed ankle too, so. Toes under, push that weight forward. Can you see how it creates that nice point, that arch in the foot? That's what we're looking for. And then simply descend, toes, push. And you want to do that on a soft surface because otherwise it hurts. Good. And we should always wriggle the toes, flex the feet after if that was tough for you. Okay. So this time we're going to do that straddle stretch, but on the instep with the belly down to start. So you can always use a wall behind you to make sure you're doing the alignment right, so you'd keep your feet and your bum on the wall. I'm lucky because I have a line on my mat and I can keep checking. Okay, so both legs to the side, and we're going to be going out on this bit, the instep. So we're just going to slide as wide as you can and just come to where you're comfortable. So if you need to stay higher, that's fine. Use some blocks to hold on to or something. And just check that your legs are in line and your bum's not too far forward. Like so. And now we're just going to relax and try and let those hips sink. I'll do this again sideways so you can see exactly what I'm doing. Okay, we're going to pull forward, bend the legs, use the toes to bring the legs together. And then when they're together, squeeze them together. Squeezing. And pushing up. Down. Okay, so like I said, I'll do it sideways now so you can see. I'm just going to move my camera back slightly because I don't think my legs will fit in. Sorry about that noise. Okay. So hopefully, here's my arm now. I've made noise. Thinks it's time to play. Okay, so I'll just wait for him to finish his drink because he will probably video for me and then you won't see what I'm doing. So if you want to circle your hips all the way, I'll skip this part. Keep those hips and nice and warm. Downward dog now, but yeah, I'm just going to put him on the couch. Here's Milo. Okay, so let's just do that again. I think you should be fine there. So on the instep, both legs. Okay, you can't contracting your leg, can you? Well, hopefully you can see that the hips and feet are in line. And we're just going to hold this stretch. If you wish, you can then pull up into toes up, like we were doing before. And let's hold up. Tailbone under if you joined me on that path. Bring those legs back. Slide forward if you were still on your tummy. Woo! Give those knees a cut up. Okay, so just give those knees a rock. Feet together, toes up, we're nearing the end now. Bringing those hands all the way over, try and grab the toes, lift those heels off the floor, and low with the body. Think about having a nice flat back. Do the same, reaching over. Nice. Okay, everyone, I think that was pretty much the whole body. Obviously, not too much of the back, but we did legs and hips and shoulders, so I'm happy with that. I hope you are too. Yes, and please remember to subscribe. I will see you soon.